Okay, Mr. President, first let me wish you and all of my colleagues a happy and healthy new year. I hope everyone traveling across the country remains safe in the face of these recent winter storms. This morning, let me begin with a few words on the loss of our dear friend, our beloved former leader, and one of the brightest stars to ever serve in the U.S. Senate, our former colleague, Harry Reid of Searchlight, Nevada, as he would proudly refer to himself. Harry Reid, in short, was one of the most incredible individuals I've ever met, the sort of person you come across only a handful of times in your entire life. He was tough as nails, a fighter to his core, but also one of the most compassionate individuals you could imagine. To lose Harry Reid is like losing track of the North Star. There are many in this chamber who got to where they are because of him. Next Wednesday, January 12th, Harry will make his final return to the U.S. Capitol, where he'll lie in state under the rotunda. As we honor his life and legacy, I'll have more to say in the coming days. But for now, I can only say that Harry was my leader, my mentor, one of my dearest friends. When you lose someone who is as close to us as Harry was, they're never truly gone. They'll always stay with us. As we gavel in today, I take comfort knowing that Harry is with us in spirit, walking alongside us as we continue to work, he dedicated himself to for so many years. To Harry's family, to his wife Landra, to all the children and grandchildren, I offer my prayers and my condolences.